that they can write into us here at Pebble Mill. Thank you all very much.
Thank you, Marion. Well, this young man I don't think needs any introduction. He is, of course, Paul King of the group King, one of the best British bands. Aren't you, chap?
Yes.
Well, as we saw there in that item about heroin, how do you, and this is a very serious subject, how do you actually feel about it? Because pop stars are seen as people that young people emulate.
Well, the actual effects of bands or artists on their audience are, I think, are probably debatable depending on the group of thought. But like last year, for instance, there were a number of artists and bands who come out and spoke against heroin. And I think if at the end of the day it stops one person or a group of people from dabbling with drugs, then it's got to be a useful course
to take. Did you yourself actually get involved in that?
What I've done personally, I didn't get involved with the anti-heroin campaign, though potentially there are a number of, in the wake of Live Aid, live performances coming up, there's an anti-heroin concert which King, if we're around the country, would possibly get involved in at the Hammersmith Odeon. What I've done personally is, from my own hometown and the guy's hometown, Coventry, I've done a thing there for schools. Excuse me, I've got a frog in my throat. A thing there for schools, which is based at kids. I mean, the kids who are actually being affected and who this drug is being pumped to. It's just saying, don't dabble. And if, as I say, if I actually affect somebody and they don't do it, then it's worthwhile.
Well, we can but hope that it has a considerable effect. Well, let's talk about you now. When I saw you last year, you were in the middle of your second British tour.
Yeah.
You've now done a third, and you've been all around Europe. How did it go?
Great. We had a fantastic time. It was the Bittersweet Album Tour, which we did the UK one more time. We went to Holland, Belgium, France, Germany, Italy, and said hello to a lot of foreigners.
Were they good to you? Were they kind to you?
It varied. The best place for total extremes was like Italy. We had fantastic receptions there and also some wild reactions. But King have always been a band who's brought the best of personalities out of people. We've evoked emotions.
Now, I've been reading that you're actually going to be doing a promo trip to Japan. Are you big in Japan? That used to be a terrible saying, didn't it? Big in Japan, that you
would... We're just starting there. I mean, the Japanese, as an audience, is a place where they're very, very into Western bands. I think they're very interested in our culture, as we're very interested in their culture. They like bands who have a strong visual presence, as King have always promoted. And so we're getting our fan mail from there, and the Japanese record company think this is our year for Japan, so we're going over there.
How about the Big Apple, America?
America is that. It's the Big Apple, and it takes a lot of bites to actually make your way into it. We went over there in September and had a very good tour, but it's such a huge place. You've got to keep going over there and playing and playing.
I have to mention that I saw this thing in the Mirror this morning which said that you considered yourself to be a very likely chat show host. And you could easily replace Terry Wogan.
Yeah, well, I think we need some new young faces on the TV, so I'm going for that one.
Are you nervous now, this very minute?
Very.
Are you?
Just because you're here, you make me very
nervous.
You said
in the paper that you never got nervous.
I do, of course I do.
Now, how about acting? It seems to me that a lot of pop stars eventually make the transition onto the silver screen, Sting being the prime example. Do you ever see yourself?
David Bowie. I don't know. I mean, personally, I get a lot of satisfaction and creative challenge from King and from music, and I think there's a lot more we've got to do before I'd even consider sort of branching out into that area.
We're talking of a lot more. What about a new album? Are you working on one at the moment?
Well, that's what we're doing. We're writing material. I don't think it'd be something we'd be recording until the summer, which potentially means it's going to be an autumn album or maybe even 1987. Such is the way it goes. We have to go and see the world now.
Well, we wish you all the very best, with all and everything included.
Thank you.
And you're going to sing now?
Yes. Taste of Your Tears.
How wonderful. Thank you.
Okay.
What I have, that's
Taste of Your Tears from King. You know, it's hard to imagine that around the time that the men of